Boyle County, Kentucky High School, where she graduated. Danielle loved the school band, and the money will go to students majoring in music education in college. As for Jason Bond, he was placed in a special unit in prison for inmates who need to be separated for their own safety from the general population. Jason's mother will pay for his appeal. For 48 Hours on ID, I'm Maureen Maher. Thanks for watching.
This program contains material that may be disturbing to some viewers. Parental discretion is advised.
NA, it's that bill expected to be signed by the president. Hello and welcome to a brand new hour of America's News Headquarters. I'm Eric Schon.
Hi, Eric, and hello, everyone. I'm Arthel Neville. Well, the order comes after the House and Senate voted almost unanimously to slap new sanctions on Russia for its alleged interference in last year's election, despite objections from President Trump. And this as the Homeland Security Secretary, retired Marine Corps General John Kelly, prepares to take on his new role as the President's Chief of Staff, replacing the ousted Wright Priebus tomorrow, possibly signaling a new stability in the White House.
And Evan Keller right now is live at the White House for preview of what we can expect when the cabinet meeting starts and General Kelly is sworn in. So, first of all, let's start with what are we hearing from the White House on the U.S. having to cut the staff in Moscow?
Nothing from the White House as of yet this afternoon, nothing from the National Security Council, and from the State Department, only the most benign of statements, which reads, quote, "It is our policy not to compromise with individuals serving at our missions abroad." That said, according to Reuters, the Russian Foreign Ministry said that the U.S. has until September 1st to reduce its diplomatic staff in Russia to 455 people. It ordered the expulsion of 755 diplomats. So if you do the math, it means that there are over 1,200 Americans serving in Russia before this Russian order took effect. Russia has also shuttered two U.S. diplomatic retreats in Russia, including this one, Anako, a country house, which is just outside of Moscow. This all comes a day after Congress overwhelmingly voted to impose these new sanctions on Russia. Today, Vice President Pence, who is traveling in Eastern Europe and is presently visiting Estonia, told our Kristen Fisher, who is traveling with him, that he expects the president to sign this Russia sanctions bill.
Do you anticipate President Trump to sign the Russia sanctions bill while you are over here? And if so, how will that bolster your message?
Well, the president's made it very clear that Russia's destabilizing activities, its support for rogue regimes, its activities in Ukraine are unacceptable. And the president made it very clear that very soon he will sign the sanctions from the Congress of the United States to reinforce them. But at the same time, as we make our intentions clear, that we expect Russian behavior to change.
Also germane to this new Russia crisis right now, yesterday the president retweeted this from Fox and Friends, quote, "Firm behind anti-Trump dossier also worked for Russia, according to Senate witness." And then the president added his own comment on that, quote, "In other words, Russia was against Trump in the 2016 election, and why not? I want strong military and low oil prices. Witch hunt." This all has a lot of echoes of Cold War tensions, not Cold War collusion, Eric.
Yeah, 755 diplomats, 20 times more than the number of diplomats that President Obama expelled from the U.S. in December. Remember that? We expelled 35 at the time, so this is really ratcheted up. Meanwhile, Dr. Pallison, cheering at the White House continues. General John Kelly, expected to be sworn in tomorrow's White House Chief of Staff. What's the latest on what we can expect?
As you say, he does take the reins officially tomorrow for the first time. It is going to be his mission to help plug leaks here, to tighten the reins of this ship of Spain, to make it more disciplined. The question lurking for Kelly is, can he instill discipline in the chain of command upwards as well as downwards? His boss may also potentially ignite another firestorm for this White House if he carries through on his promise to let Obamacare implode by stopping CSR payments, cost savings reduction payments, which are helping to prop up insurance. Here's Kellyanne Conway speaking about this on Fox News Sunday.
He's going to make that decision this week, and that's a decision that only he can make.
So it's into this maelstrom that Kelly will step tomorrow. No easy task. Eric, back to you.
Well, he's going to be about to force. Oh, please. see what they can face, Doug, back here. So for more on what is up with General Kelly, Judy Miller joins us, adjunct fellow at the Manhattan Institute for Policy Research, Pulitzer Prize-winning author and journalist and Fox News contributor. So Judy, you think General Kelly, can he crack the whip? Can he right the ship? Is he going to take names and kick you know what?
Well, I think he can if the problem was Reince Priebus and a lack of discipline within the White House staff. But as even Republicans have begun to say, the problem was not Reince Priebus. The problem was the president and his own lack of discipline when it came to doing what his staff were urging him to do. I mean, Donald Trump is his own chief of staff. And he wants to do what he's going to do. He was told even by his family, by Jared Kushner, by Ivanka, that tweeting was not helping, that it was driving down his poll numbers, and yet he continues
treat.
To do it. He will not stop.
You want a treat?
So the issue is, can John Kelly really get him to do things that the president wouldn't normally instinctively want to do?
And
no one knows the answer to that. I think that Trump is going to be Trump. And, you know, rabid Trumpsters will say, that's just great, that's why we elected him. But those who want to get something done, who are just appalled by what happened to the health care bill, who are appalled that there's been so little reaction to North Korea, who stand around and watch the White House reaction to Venezuela falling apart, becoming a dictatorship, they say, where is the president? He's missing action on the most important issues confronting this country. Instead, we're arguing about moving the deck chairs around on the quote Titanic, which is what some Republicans are beginning to say.
Well,
and is
he really missing an action, or is there work going on?
No more.
That's enough.
It's just not covered, and it's not generally targeted about. You know, it's just not covered this weekend. We were certainly looking at health care, but you just mentioned, you know, democracy may be dead in Venezuela. You've got North Korea, we've heard a lot about that. I mean, how do those issues play into General Kelly being the chief of staff?
Well, you know, the White House is very upset about leaks. I think if there was a great deal going on in these areas, we would know about it because there were leaks. But there haven't been on these substantive issues. I have been doing a lot of reporting because I just came back, Eric, as you know, from Israel, about the danger of Israel being surrounded on 3 out of its 4 borders by Iran. And that means you have to have a Syria policy that American can get behind that protects our allies like Israel, but we don't have